Nadia Murad refused to be shamed and refused to be silenced. 4 years ago, ISIL fighters attacked her village in northern Iraq. She was taken captive and sold repeatedly for sex.
He humiliated me every day. He forced me to wear clothes that didn't cover my body. I was tortured. I tried to flee, but one of the guards stopped me, and that night he beat me. He asked me to take my clothes off and put me in a room with guards. Then they proceeded to commit their crime, and I fainted.
Since she escaped from ISIL-controlled Mosul, she has fought to put the suffering of the persecuted Yazidi minority in Iraq in the global spotlight.
There were thousands of Yazidi families and children who were exchanged as gifts. One of these people came up to me. He wanted to take me. I was absolutely petrified. He looked like a monster. I cried and said, "I am too young and you're huge." He beat me.
The Nobel Peace Prize for 2018 to Denis Mukwege and Nadia Murad.
On Friday, the 25-year-old became the first Iraqi to be awarded the Nobel Peace Prize, unimaginable 4 years ago. Murad was living in the mountains of Sinjar in the Yazidi community of about 500,000. Yazidis practice an ancient religion. ISIL deems them heretics. When ISIL fighters swept into Murad's village, she was kidnapped. She and thousands of other girls and women were forced into sexual slavery. After 3 months, she escaped and made her way to Germany, where she now lives. Her family was not so lucky. Her mother and six of her brothers were killed.
I implore you, get rid of ISIL completely. I went through this terrible suffering because of them. I've seen what they've done to boys and girls. All those who commit crimes of human trafficking and genocide need to be brought to justice so that women and children can live in peace.
Murad has spent the last 4 years forcing the world to reckon with rape as a weapon of war. She has also spread awareness about the Yazidis and ensured no one forgets about the thousands who remain missing. Natasha Ghoneim, Al Jazeera.